powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
God, this is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad. Today, as we pray, we expect to be empowered by the Spirit. And God has called us into the Spirit-led life. If you truly want to walk in victory, you have to respond to the leading of God's Spirit. And when we respond to the leading of His Spirit, nothing can be impossible to us. It is the reason why we have to pray, is that when we pray, we'll create an atmosphere where we can see possibilities, where we can see supernatural release, where we can see preferential treatment. And today, we'll be praying that we will walk in the fullness of the things of the Spirit. You know, sometimes someone can be a believer in the body of Christ, but they are not having the kind of manifestations, visitations of the Spirit, encounters that they desire to have. They are not experiencing the move of God in their life. They are not experiencing the outpouring of the Holy Ghost the way they should. There is this dryness in them, and there is no flow of the things of the Spirit. And sometimes when people don't have the flow of the things of the Spirit, Christianity could be boring. It could be boring to read the Bible. People read the Bible, they don't have revelations, they don't have encounters, they don't have visitation, you know. So it looks like the whole thing is not working. But the truth of the matter is that we need the flow of the Spirit to have manifestation. We need the involvement of the person of the Holy Spirit. You can't read the Bible except by the Spirit. This is where a lot of people open the book called the Bible. They read it, but they never had an experience with God. They never had an encounter with God. They never had a visitation. It like just the one religious book they read. But this Bible was meant to be the voice of God to you, bringing you inspiration, bringing you revelation, bringing you direction. Now, it is by the Spirit we'll begin to make the connection. And without the ministry of the Holy Spirit, we cannot successfully enjoy our walk with God. Without the ministry of the Holy Ghost, we cannot successfully enjoy our walk with God. So as we pray right now in the Spirit, you got to be spiritually sensitive to know that God wants you to go to the next dimension. You've been in this place for 5 years, for 10 years, you know, the same spiritual experience, the same, you know, nothing is really happening that is fresh or new in your walk with God. So sometimes some believers become obsolete. They are no longer having the kind of visitation. Sometimes it happens to a preacher. The preacher has been in ministry, but now it's becoming dry. You know, there is no flow in revelation. There is no flow in visitation. There are no manifestations of the things of the Spirit. If we are not careful, we can become obsolete. But as we pray this morning, you know, the title of this today's prayer section is Empowered by the Spirit, that the Holy Ghost will empower you, that you will have the flow of the Spirit to do the things God wants you to do. Without the flow of the Spirit, you have a struggle. This is where a lot of people are running from place to place to get results, to get solution. They are running from this camp meeting, from this meeting, from this place. Peradventure, God will speak to them. But it was not meant to be that way. You see, when we go for Christian fellowship or meetings. It should be a place where we can receive the word of God. Not that I'm really going to this place because God will speak to me in this place. But God can speak to me in my bedroom. God can speak to me when I'm driving my car. God can speak to me while I'm driving. God can speak to me while I'm doing exercise. So the flow of the Spirit is our focus today. As we pray, expect the flow. As we pray, expect visitation. Expect to go to the next level in your walk with God. You can't stay dry. You can't remain where you are. So as we pray right now, begin to expect divine release. Let's begin to thank the Lord. Le karaba sontobo. Le kento robo sakari garaba sokori garaba. Le kratos keto robo sakandari korobo sheketoli gababa. Re karaba sokotoli krama sontonomo santali gababa. Re krado seketoli kraba seketoli blakandari bo sokotoli blagada. Re kandare bo seketoli kraba sotori kraba seketoli blakababa. Nolo shetola la man lo bobo shatan de de bo seketari babababa. Rakanda likambra doske toli kramba santo toli kramba santo toli kramba lekida doske toro boshata la baligra do boso tolo boshe toli gababa rikanda rikoro boshe kotoli kramba soko toli kramba sata la gababa rikanda raba soko toli kramba soko toli kramba baba moshe tola malida da bradoske toro boshata li kramba rababa lekaba li toro bosaka tala bladeske toli kramba soko toli kramba baba riketori kramba Sokotole kababababa, rikorobo sokotole kraba sokotole klaba sokotole klababa, monse kandari brakababababa, likaraba sokotole klaba sokotole klababa, mengerebo sokotole blakandaraba sokotole blakarababa, rikondorobo sokandali blakandaraba kababa, mundorobo sokotole klaba sokotole klababa, norombo shantala kladiske torobo sotetegli gadabridos ketorebra desketolimbra. Mendingre de seketo lambro los que to lingra de seketo lingra baso koto lingra baba brede seketo ribra de seketo lika baba roche keto likla baso keto likla baba in the name of Jesus. Psalm 119 verse 105. In Psalm 119 verse 105, he said, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." Your word is a lamp unto my feet. Your word is a lamp unto my feet. Let's begin to pray right now that the word of God will come afresh in our spirit. The word of God will come afresh in our spirit. As we go into the word, as we read the scriptures, we'll begin to experience visitations of the Spirit. As you have your study time, as you begin to read the word of God, there will be a visitation from heaven. Begin to pray right now. Bolobo sakala kangrados ketole kraba sokotole kababa. Mendere kema su kandari graba sokotole kaparado seketole blagada. Ringo lomo shakan la blagada. Ringo robo shakan la blades ketole glababa. Mele kandari grodo seketoram brodo seketorim rakatababa. Le kambrades ketole kaparando seketoli la kababa. Likambra de seketoli kamaraba seketoli kababa. Rikanda rabra gadama sokondorobo seketoli glababa. Rikanda ribrodo seketori grababa seketori gragada. Bredeske tulambra doske toli kraba sokotoli kraba sototoli krababa. Rikambra doske toli kabaraba seketoli blagada. In the name of Jesus, we're praying from Psalm 119. Verse 105, Psalm 119, verse 105. He said, "Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path." His word is a lamp unto our feet. His word is a lamp unto our dream. Malu shede kedi kabrados ketunda laklades ketolamblili keperondo menene sanana kotoni kananina masute dento masunto mbredese tento nomosunto nomosunto nomosunto. Santani mama Likandaraba baba, likandaraba sokotoli kraba sokontolo baba. Mlediske torobo santari kraba sotontori kraba sotati kraba baba. Rikondorobo seketoli blakada baba. In the name of Jesus, glory be to God. Brodoske tolamra deske toli kaba baba. Likandaraba baba baba. In the name of Jesus, in Psalm 119 verse 88, Psalm 119 verse 88, he said, "Quicken me after thy loving kindness, quicken me." You know, sometimes we need a quickening of the Spirit. You know, a lot of people want to flow in power, but they are not quickened. Someone can be dull spiritually. Someone could be dull, not being sensitive to the things of the spirit. And a lot of people are in that state. They are dull. They are dull. They can't respond to the things of the spirit. They are dull spiritually. They are not smart when it comes to the things of the spirit. So the psalmist here said, quicken me after thy loving kindness, so shall I keep the testimony of thy mouth, Quicken me. We're going to pray this morning that the Lord will quicken you from any form of slumber spiritually, any form of slumber, any form, you know, sometimes someone could be on fire for God, but suddenly they start slowing down, you know, they start backsliding. They are no more where they used to be. They used to spend 3 hours to pray, 1 hour to pray, 45 minutes to pray, but now they can't even pray for 5 minutes. They can't even stand in the place of prayer for 5 minutes. So let's pray that the Lord will quicken us. Let there be a quickening in your spirit. Pray for quickening in the name of Jesus. We pray for quickening. We pray for supernatural quickening. A supernatural quickening. Concerning the vision, concerning the dream, concerning the assignment. A supernatural quickening by the Spirit of God that were quickened. In the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. In Psalm 119 verse 128, he said, therefore I esteem all thy precepts concerning all things to be right, and I hate every false way. Wow. He said, I esteem, look at this. He said, therefore, I esteem all thy precepts concerning all things. We're going to pray right now that concerning your life, concerning all things, that the word of God will take the lead. That the word of God will take the lead. Let's begin to pray. Lord, we esteem your word. We esteem your word. Limbe limbe lobo shendeli gababa. We esteem your word. Likandaraba seketoli blagada. We esteem your precept concerning all things, concerning our vision, concerning our ministry, concerning our relationship, concerning our calling. In the name of Jesus, amen. Glory be to God. In the name of Jesus, let's pray from this scripture, Matthew chapter 5, verse 6. In Matthew 5, verse 6, it said, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness. Blessed are they who do hunger. You know, spiritual hunger is the key to spiritual growth. If you're going to grow spiritually, if you're going to make progress in the things of the Spirit, there has to be continuous hunger. Hunger to encounter God, hunger to have visitations, hunger to have encounters, hunger to have great release of the Spirit. There has to be hunger in your spirit. He said here in Matthew 5, verse 6, he said, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Let's begin to pray right now. Lord, increase my hunger level. Lord, stir up my hunger. My hunger for the things of the Spirit, my hunger to fellowship with your word, my hunger to pray in the Holy Ghost, my hunger, hunger, hunger for the things of the Spirit, that I am hungry for God's word, I'm hungry to be in his presence, I'm hungry to encounter him. May I not be satisfied with my present visitation, with my present experience. May I not be satisfied with my spiritual state. Hunger. Hunger in the name of Jesus. This is one key factor that made the ministry of Jesus to be successful. He was always hungry for God. He always wants to be in the presence of God. He always wants to encounter God. He was not satisfied with the miracle of yesterday. He's coming back today to heal the blind. He's coming back to heal the sick. He's coming back to do all kinds of miracles. Every day Jesus was seeing miracles. Every day Jesus was seeing miracles. And Jesus should be our focus. We should be able to live like Jesus. He's our senior brother. We should be able to live like Jesus, to see miracles, to see healing. We're going to pray right now. Now we're going to walk in the flow of the Spirit. Walk, Lord, cause me to flow in the flow of the Spirit. Cause me to walk in the flow of the Spirit. Begin to pray for yourself right now. Lord, I want to manifest the flow of the Spirit. Lord, cause me to manifest the flow of the Spirit. The flow of the Spirit. The flow of the Spirit. Cause me to walk in the flow of the Spirit. In the flow of the Spirit, that I will be spiritually sensitive, I'll be spiritually strategic. The flow of the Spirit. The flow of the Spirit, visitation from heaven, visitation from heaven, visitation from heaven. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Ghost. No shelia la labia to tumba. Mredeske to manina na tanteliko no link na deske to lika mbradoske to lika bababa. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. I feel the power of God in this place right now. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Father. We're going to pray right now that, Lord, you're going to lead me concerning growing up in the things of the Spirit. You know, sometimes you want to grow, but you don't know where to go. You don't know who to hook up with. You don't know the ministry to connect with. It's not every ministry that could help a person grow. There are ministries that could help someone develop. There are some ministries people are just wasting their time. I'm sorry to say this, but I just have to say the truth. They are just wasting their time, their energy, and resources because they are not growing in the things of the Spirit. They are not getting better in their walk with God. They are not developing. We're going to pray right now, Lord, lead me concerning spiritual growth. Lead me. I need the leading of the Spirit. Maybe sometimes God could lead us into material, could lead us into someone who is teaching the Word of God. You know, sometimes we could be around someone that could help us grow, but we don't maximize the relationship. You know, I often say to people, what you don't honor, you can't benefit from. So we're going to pray right now because we need to grow. We can't be where we are. You're going to pray right now, Lord. Number one, I need to make time for your word. You need to make time for the word. This is why we have the Faithman teaching on YouTube. More than 970 videos on YouTube now. This is why we need to stay connected to the word of God and listen to it all the time. And also praying that you'll be able to make time for the word. Some of us don't make time for the word. Some of us are busy about businesses, which is good. But if you're not developing spiritually, how do you make a difference? How do you make progress with your life? How do you make right decision concerning your job, concerning this area of life? You need to be led by the Spirit of God. So the whole thing that we're praying about right now is that, Lord, lead me. Romans 8:14, he said, as men that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. So we're going to pray right now, dear Spirit of God, lead me. Lead me. I don't want to lead myself. I'm tired of leading myself. I'm tired of trying to help myself. Lord, lead me. Let's begin to pray right now in the Spirit. Lord, maliko robo shetori gabaredo sekundoli kamaba. Lendi rebo seketali kamaraba seketali gababa. Supernatural leading by the Spirit of God. Supernatural leading by the Holy Ghost. Lo shokotoli bo shekendeli kababa. Rikaraba shokotoli kabaraba seketoli glababa. Rikatoli brade seketoli kabarado seketoli blagada. Supernatural leading by the Holy Ghost. Meloka prados ketoro bo shakala kaplades ketoli kambarababa. Leka mazuka talambo shokotoli kambrades ketoli kabababa. Rikondoro bo shokot Lobo Sokotolibra de Sketolika Baba, Rekondo Robo Sokotolibra de Sketolika Baba, supernatural leading by the Holy Ghost, supernatural leading by the Holy Ghost, Moya Kataliko Robo Sokotoliga Baba. Mashokotolika baba baba baba, likundorobo sokotoligla baba baba, likundorobo sokotoligla baba baba, likandaraba sokotoligla gada baba baba, rikundorobo sokotoligla baba. Supernatural leading by the Holy Ghost, supernatural leading by the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus, we pray that, amen. Immersed in the Word. We need to be immersed in God's Word. And if you're watching this broadcast right now, you need to dwell in the Word of God. You know, the desire to read the Word. The desire to fellowship with the Word. The desire, the passion. This is where you grow from. You grow by spending quality time with the Word. Quality time in reading, quality time in listening. Don't drive your car most of the time without listening to God's Word. So you can just go to that Faithman teaching on YouTube and just get something connected. And while you're driving for 1 hour, for 2 hours, you're listening to something. You're listening. Don't drive without listening to God's Word. This is what I do. I was up this morning going to somewhere to fix something. I was listening to the Word of God. I was listening to T.L. Osborne. T.L. Osborne is a great man of God that has gone home to be with the Lord. I have some of his material. So I was just listening to T.L. Osborne and listening to those powerful testimonies of faith, how healing and miracles took place, you know, in India, in Japan, you know, the things he did, you know. I was listening to him driving. You know, faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. I have to listen to the Word of God. You see, when you keep listening to the Word of God, it refreshes you. There's a refreshing. So don't drive your car going for business or just listen to something. If you go to Faithman Teaching on YouTube, you have 900 and something videos. You could do a playlist. You can maybe could select videos on prayers or something. You could just be watching or finishworktv.com. You could just on it and it's just playing and you're hearing the teaching and you're driving. And by so doing, there is a refreshing. Always put yourself in a spiritual condition where you are always alert. Always put yourself in a spiritual condition. So let's pray right now that you'll be making the decision to hear more of God's word. So can we declare operation listening to 100 videos in the next 1 month? For everybody watching me around the world. So you go to Faithman Teaching, 100 videos for 1 month. You're listening to it, you're playing, you're watching, you're listening. So faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. So operation, listen to 100 videos. So you can do 5 videos every day. Some of the videos are 20 minutes, some are 30 minutes, some are 1 hour. You know, while you're driving to work for 1 hour, you listen. Before getting to your office, you played over 2 videos. Maybe you're coming back from office, you've listened to 2 videos. Maybe during break, you've done one. Your spiritual condition will improve. Your spiritual state will improve. This is how you improve your spiritual state. There are things people can't do for you. You got to do it for yourself. So you're driving to work, you're playing 2 videos. You're coming back from work, you're doing 2. When you're done, maybe during your break. So go to finishworktv.com or go to Faithman Teaching on YouTube. We have so many teachings, so many prayers. You can't be listening. I used to listen to them. Sometimes I listen to them. One day I was listening to one of the teachings. There was a kind of fire that's exploded in my spirit. I just knew I contacted something that day. So imagine if me could go back to that place and listen and listen. Faith cometh by hearing and hearing by the word of God. So we declare operation, listen to 100 videos in 1 month to build up your spiritual life. To build up your spiritual life. Let's begin to pray right now that the passion to go for the word, the passion to read the word, to listen to the word will increase. These are the keys to supernatural empowerment. These are the keys to being empowered by the Spirit. That the hunger, that you be diligent in hearing the word, in doing the word. That you be diligent in the word of God. You be diligent in the things of the Spirit. As you listen, you write down the message you're listening. You write down your experience, what you encountered while you listen to that teaching. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Amen. You can have a list of the 100 videos. Maybe you listen to teaching on faith, you know, you write the subject down, you write what you've listened to, what you've followed up, you begin to develop yourself, you will notice that in 1 month time, you will grow so rapidly that you'll be shocked, that you'll be the one ministering to people, praying for people, healing the sick, doing things, hearing from God, unknowing to us, we can set the fire up. So you can do this in 1 month, listening to 100 videos. So from whether you're going to the mall, you're in a bus, you're in a train, you know, you just put your earpiece on your phone and you're just listening and something is happening. Hallelujah. You're going to bring out your earpiece out right now. So everything, get ready to come out because we are on a spiritual growth project. So we're having 1 month spiritual growth project. Everyone watching me around the world, 1 month spiritual growth project. So listening to the word, praying in the spirit. Maybe you pray in the spirit for 30 minutes, for 45 minutes, and by so doing, you're rising in your faith walk. And this is how you see manifestation. This is how you see greater release of the things of the spirit. Father, we thank you. Oh, let's pray. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Holy Ghost, Lee Shotolikamba, Masha Kababa, Reto Sokotoliklaba, Seketoliklaba. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Let there be an outpouring in your faith work. Let there be an outpouring in everything you do. Let there be an outpouring of the release of the Spirit. Let there be miracles right now. I pray for visitation of the Spirit. I pray for you to have more encounters with the Holy Ghost. I pray that your prayer life will be on fire again. I pray you're going to pray for more time, for more hours. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Someone just receive right now. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive strength for the vision. Receive wisdom for the vision. Receive encounter. Receive visitation. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Thank you, Holy Ghost. Empowered by the Spirit in the name of Jesus. Receive strength in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Amen. If you're praying with us today and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth. I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray this prayer with me, it means you're born again and the Holy Ghost is going to help you. So I encourage you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. You have more than 970 videos to watch and more. Keep adding every day. We'll keep uploading. We'll keep upgrading the YouTube channel for people to be able to receive the Word of God. And also, thank you very much. Over 1,000 videos. You can choose from 1,000. Thank you very much. Over 1,000 videos right now. So you can watch and you will never remain the same. Now, I want to encourage you to keep watching finishworktv.com. This is a place of inspiration and revelation. So you can go to finishworktv.com and watch a lot of teaching 24/7 every day. You know, I'm there. You can take me to your office. How do you keep me around you? Is to go to finishworktv.com. You can tap it. Apostle Faithman is up here teaching on faith, teaching on healing, teaching on miracle, praying for somebody to be healed. Hallelujah. So you just go there, keep watching. Keep watching me on Finishwork TV. This is a place of inspiration and wisdom. Hallelujah. And also, you can reach out to me through friend requests on Facebook. On Facebook, it's Faithman Ogboada or Faithman Ogboada Ministry. So when you go to Facebook, you can connect with me to receive a lot of revelation, inspiration, and understanding that can change your way of doing things and inspire you to take the lead in the direction of God's will. And also, I want to encourage you to stay committed to this ministry because the Word of God is here and it's helping a lot of people. So you can partner with us on PayPal. On PayPal is faithmanteaching@gmail.com. Partnership is important in changing the lives of people around the world. So every day I'm coming here, bringing forth the Word of God, teaching people all over the world. So I just want you to partner with us. Through partnership, we're changing life, and we'll have multiple broadcasts every day, helping more people around the world. Thank you for partnering with us on PayPal. It's faithmanteaching@gmail.com. Together, you and I is helping people to have a new history, empowering them to live the God life. We love you. Until my next broadcast, don't ever forget this. There is greatness in you.